Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another video. Today's video is about dealing with negative emotions. Where do they come from? What are they trying to tell us? How do we get rid of them? So negative emotions are the same as positive emotions. It's just information. And the way that I invite you to start looking at your emotions is look at them as signals. Signals as to what direction in life you are heading into. So all it is, again, is our emotions are a guidance system. How we feel is a guidance system. So if you think about something that you like or that makes you happy and that makes you feel good, it's very simple. That's what you should go towards, because we should always go towards what makes us feel good. And it's really that simple. And negative emotions, how we deal with them, is simply as, again, information. So if there are negative emotions, think about what you're thinking about. What is it that you're feeling? What are those emotions? Is it anger? Is it sadness? Is it, you know, grief? Is it disgust? Is it judgment? Is it resentment? Whatever emotions you're feeling, what are the thoughts or the situations that you're thinking about that are having you feel that way? Because whatever those situations are, those relationships, the job, whatever it is you don't want in life, that's all that it's showing you. It's just information and showing you what you should not be doing or who you should not be around. So, you know, if you think about that friend that you always argue with, and you always get upset or start feeling upset or like in turmoil or some kind of negative thing that makes you feel like ugh or whatever it is, however it makes you feel, well then that is a friend or a situation that you clearly should not spend time around or be around. And it's really that simple. And sometimes, you know, these emotions pop up, the negative ones, to show us what we don't like. And you know, you say, okay, you know, well, I'm not just going to give up, you know, on my brother or sister just because I argue with them every time. No, it doesn't mean you completely have to cut them off, but at the same time, you're allowed to if you feel that that's what's best for you. I mean, if you have an abusive parent who's been abusive to you your whole entire life, you owe them no obligation to continue to interact with them if all that ever comes out of it is a negative emotional response from you. Because they're honestly just a toxic relationship in your life. The label of family doesn't necessarily mean that you are obligated to them, you know, and that's, I know that triggers a lot of people when I say that, but it's the truth of it. You know, if you had somebody, in other words, this is an extreme example, but it's the same thing. If you had, you know, someone who constantly just talked down to you and made you feel like crap just because they feel like crap every time, you don't have to stick around. You don't have to take that abuse. You don't have to be around that person just because they're your mother, father, your sister, uncle, cousin, whoever it is. You can say, I don't want to be around that person. I'm trying to be around that energy. I don't want to be around people who, you know, constantly talk down to me. That's me personally. You might want to. I don't. I'm guessing you don't. And so, again, bringing it back to the theme of this particular video, your emotions are your internal guidance system as to what situations you should or should not be around. So if it's a negative emotion and, you know, you are hating your job and you feel drained, you feel unfulfilled, it makes you frustrated, you know, you're just not happy, well, clearly that's not a job or a location or a vocation or whatever you're doing that you should do any longer. So that negative emotion is giving you a signal that, okay, it's time to make a change. Because we're here on Earth for a short time. And just like Drake says, man, I'm here for a good time, not a long time. And that's the damn truth of it. Because you may live 100 years, you know, and think about the time span of life, of Earth's history. It's much longer than 100 years. So we really aren't here for a long time. So make it a good time while you're here. And use your emotions as information to guide you along the path as to what and who you should be around and what you should be doing. So great, man. Use it as information. You don't like that job. You hate it. Okay, so it's time to switch. Okay, you know, if that triggers you and there's all this stuff that comes up, well, I can't because I have a mortgage and a kids and blah, blah, blah. Okay, well, stick in your job and keep hating it then. It's your choice. Nobody's going to do anything for you. No one's coming to save you. Or you can say, okay, I don't like this job and I do have responsibilities. What are the solutions, or how can I start moving things around in my life so that I can go towards what it is I want? Well, what would make me happy? It all starts with questions. So that's the next step, is once we identify what these emotions are, whether positive or negative, use that as information as to what you want to start building into your life. So, you know, you think about, God, you know, I just had lunch with Fred. I love Fred, man. Every single time I'm around Fred, I feel really good. I feel really good. I come out of the interaction like uplifted and positive and like happy. And I love Fred. Fred's amazing. Well, great. You should be spending more time with people and around people like Fred, you know? And you're like, God, every time I talk to Susan, she's so freaking negative to be around. Well, don't be around Susan. Again, the feelings, how you feel are your internal guidance system. And it's a reflection of your own energy as well. But I'll make another video about that, because I want to stay on focus about using your emotions and dealing with them and using it as an opportunity to guide you towards what you want. So use that, and it's very simple. I even have it written on my whiteboard right here. Focus on and do what feels good. And it's that simple. So I bring this video up because I've been watching a lot of Abraham and Esther Hicks on YouTube. I've mentioned them before. They wrote a book called Ask and It Is Given. Basically, Esther Hicks is a medium. She's a channel for a group of spirits called Abraham. And you can find them all over them. They've been around for decades now, sharing the message. And I've actually got a lot of clarity of things in my life. And what Abraham Hicks talks about is like, look, it's very simple. However you feel is just information as to what is right and what is not right, or what you like and what you don't like in your life. And it's that simple. And again, using that Drake quote, I'm here for a good time, not a long time. Well, look, we're here for a good time. So you should only do what feels good. And now what's happened is, and what they always talk about too, is that we've been programmed to think there's no way we can feel good all the time. There's no way, right? That's just not possible. And you're right. It's not gonna happen all the time. You're gonna encounter situations. You're gonna encounter people. You're gonna encounter locations, different things you're doing, activities that you don't like, where you go, ugh, I don't like it. So again, the theme of this conversation is that is information for you to explore what you like and what you don't like. And it gives you an opportunity to create more of what you like. They call it contrast, and that's what it is. It's showing you the contrast. Man, I really like pineapple and Canadian bacon pizza. Man, I hate like meat lover's pizza. I don't like that. Ugh, it just makes me feel gross. Even when I eat it, doesn't feel right. Okay, great. So that's the contrast between the two different types of pizzas. You should eat more pineapple, Canadian bacon pizza, or vice versa. Whatever your preferences are, you understand the idea and underlying theme about what I'm sharing is that each experience, each relationship is showing us what we like and what we don't like and what we need to create more of in our lives in order to be happier people. You should always go towards more of what you like. So use your these emotions as information to guide you on what you need to change in your life in order to become a happier person and create the life that you want, because nobody's keeping you where you're at except for you. And if you don't like something, no one's gonna change it but you. It's your life. It's no one else's fault but yours. And if you do like something, go towards more of that, you know? So that's what this is about. It's just about using your emotions as an emotional guidance system to show you what you like and what you don't like in order for you to become a happier person and enjoy the short time that you have on this planet. So no more or no less than that. And then here's the other thing too that I'll say before we wrap this video up today is it's all about your thinking. It's all about your thoughts. So if you feel really shitty, become aware of what you're thinking about, because whatever you're thinking about, you don't like that. So all you have to do is start thinking about shit that you do like. Think about things that you do like. Think about people and situations that you do like and start moving the needle, moving, you know, the compass, following the compass that way. That's it. And that you have the power to change your thoughts. I've used this example, and you go, oh, there's no, I don't control how I think. Yes, you do. I'm gonna give you two choices, and I use this example in another video. I'm gonna give you a yellow school bus or red airplane. Just those two images, yellow school bus, red airplane. Choose. Choose one to think about right now. Did you choose the yellow school bus or did you choose the red airplane? Neither is right or wrong, but you have a choice on what you want to focus on. I'm giving you the option right now. So let's take that a step further. This is, you know, let's say that red airplane is, something that makes you feel bad when you think about. And then the yellow school bus is something that makes you feel good when you think about it. Well, just start focusing on the yellow school bus and take the red airplane out of your mind. And it's that simple. You have a choice on what you want to focus on and what you want to think about. So you've just got to become aware of your thoughts, aware of your feelings and emotions, and then you have the power to direct what it is you're focusing on. And then to even take it a step further than that, this is also how the law of attraction works. The irony is, whatever you focus on is whatever you're attracting into your life. So if you're consistently attracting these, you know, crappy situations in your life, and you go, oh man, I hate that, blah, 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 and you continue to focus on the stuff that you hate, well, guess what you're gonna attract into your life? You're gonna attract more of that crap that you don't like. Again, this is why we want to focus on what we like and what makes us feel good and do things that make you feel good. So focus on that yellow school bus, feel better, get the red airplane thoughts out of your mind, you'll attract more of the stuff that you like over here. That's what we want. That's what our emotions are. That's how the emotional guidance system works. It's so funny how simple it is, and you're like, it can't be that simple. No, it is. But here's the thing, it isn't necessarily easy, because again, we've been programmed to think and be a certain way for so long. So it's just like learning to ride a bike for a first time, or swing a golf club, or learn a new language. That shit takes practice, and it takes consistent practice until you get better and better at it, and eventually you become a master. I'm certainly no master at it, but it is something that I'm extremely intentional and aware about now. So you're not gonna be good at it right away. You know, think about anything in your life that's worthwhile. You're not good at it right away. And if you've really been ingrained in your way of thinking for a really long time, or if you have, you know, if you've chosen to be a stubborn person and not open to change, well, shit, that's gonna take a lot of extra hard work and time. Or it might not. Again, it's your choice. So everything is a choice. Listen to your emotional guidance system, follow your heart, and create more of what you want in your life. But just remember that you have the power to choose what you want to focus on, and what you choose to focus on is what you will attract into your life. And your emotions will tell you the things that you do or do not like, or what you should or should not be focusing on. And again, it is your choice. So hopefully this was helpful today. Follow your emotional guidance system. If your emotional guidance system likes this video and it brought a smile to your face, or some awareness maybe that wasn't there before, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. This is mostly what I realize I'd like to talk about on my YouTube channel, although there's a little bit of fitness stuff mixed in. My Instagram stuff is more fitness related, but I would appreciate the like, the follow, the subscribes, share it, all that. I'm trying to expand and grow my channel. The best way to do that is push all the buttons so the YouTube algorithm likes it, with the intention, not for me, but to share these messages so that we can help other people become more positive in their lives and empower them to have better experiences and bring this awareness and this knowledge to them. I'm just another person sharing the same messages that have been shared throughout the history of time, and that's what we're here to do, is share knowledge to grow, to create more of the life that we want, because we are not here for a long time, but we are here for a good time, and it's up to us to create it. So use your emotions to create a good time in your life and a good life for you and those around you. Peace, love, and light to you and yours, and thank you for watching. We'll see you next time. Peace.